Welcome to the first part of the blockchain course, Types of Systems. To understand blockchain, we need to grasp the concept of various systems. The USP of blockchain lies in that it uses a distributed system. We need to understand the different types of systems, the pros and cons. Systems are relevant in society and in database management. In society, you can think of governments, while in database management, you can think of servers that store information. Let's start with understanding the concept of authority. There are some common definitions that you would find on the internet and in various dictionaries, such as the power or right to give orders, make decisions, and enforce obedience, or the person or organization having power or control in a particular, typically political or administrative sphere, and the power to influence others, especially because of one's commanding manner or one's recognized knowledge about something. The centers of authority is what differentiates the three systems from one another. So let's start with the first type, centralized systems. Now, centralized systems have just one point of authority, and this is where all the control is concentrated. All the processes or the decisions are carried out in this single location. However, this system makes it extremely susceptible to collapses. Meaning, any disruption in that one single center of authority can collapse the whole system. Let's start with the advantages of this. The first, it is really easy to implement, and this makes decision-making much faster. Since there is just one authority, that single authority takes the decision, and there is no consensus required. The second is that economies of scale reduces the duplication of work, which is seen sometimes with multiple authorities. Because you have just one single authority, you do not have the chance of multiple points of authority performing the same function, and this gives you economies of scale. However, this also comes with several cons. The first and the most obvious one is that there is dependence on one single authority. For data and society, think of dictatorships. Now, this makes the system unsafe, as any attack on that sole authority shall destabilize the system. Think about a server system. If you attack the primary source of information, then there is no backup, so that information is lost. Or in a government, in a dictatorship, if the dictator is taken down, there is no new leader or new form of government, and thus that system is destabilized. The second is its bureaucratic in nature, and thus it adds many layers in hierarchy. And the third is that it is not transparent and thus prone to fraud. Low transparency makes it prone to fraud. The lack of transparency will induce irresponsibility at the top layer, since that's where the power is concentrated. Some examples of these are a banking system, a food franchisee like McDonald's, or server CPUs. Now to the second type of systems, the decentralized systems. Now there are several points of authority in decentralized systems, and thus power is more diversified. This makes the system less susceptible to downfalls, as the fall of a single point of authority won't bring down the system. The hierarchy is thus flatter compared to a centralized system. Now, let us look at the pros of this. The decisions are now made much closer to the consumer. Thus, the decision-making authorities have more information about the end users of either the product or, in a government, about the people. Second, the system is less susceptible to collapses because now there are multiple points of authority. The downfall of one point is not going to bring about a destabilization of the system as we saw in centralized systems. However, the drawbacks are that there are still diseconomies of scale, as now with multiple authorities, you may have a duplication of task problem. And second, although they are safer than centralized system, they are still susceptible to collapses. Thus, they are not completely safe. A few examples of these are supply chains like Johnson & Johnson's, governments, where you have a centralized authority and a state authority, and cloud databases. And this finally brings us to the third type of systems, which are distributed systems. In distributed systems, everyone is an authority. Thus, they are virtually unsusceptible to collapses. Now, this doesn't mean that the systems can't be hacked. However, to bring down a system, one must control or alter more than 50% of the points of authority. The costs of doing this itself will erase most gains, and this will make it economically unviable to hack these systems. And finally, the hierarchy is now completely flat. Every point of authority is equal to one another, and every person, every participant in the system is a point of authority. So, everyone is equal to everyone. And thus, this brings about a flat hierarchy. Now, what are the benefits of the system? The biggest benefit that distributed systems introduce is that it removes the need for intermediaries. Second, as discussed before, they are economically unviable to bring down, and this makes them extremely safe, the safest of the three options that we've seen today. And finally, there is complete transparency, which makes the chance of someone committing fraud highly unlikely and very difficult. There are a few drawbacks, however. These include the fact that these systems are still new and the technology is still nascent. It will still take a lot of time to stabilize. And they require a massive capital investment to set up. There will be economies of scale as time goes on, but to start the system, it is very expensive. A few examples of these are cryptocurrencies and blockchain networks. This brings us to the end of the first video on distributed systems and types of systems. Now that we know what distributed systems are and how they differ and the advantages that they offer, we can now move on to understanding blockchain and why it is being called the most disruptive technology of this century. This is Agnish Bahaduri. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned for the next video on the introduction of the blockchain. Thank you.